Our next guest was at today's rally. She is Congresswoman Michelle Bachmann, Republican of Minnesota and founder of the Tea Party Caucus. Congresswoman, great to see you. Thank you for being here. Now, we know that you are willing to go the distance to a shutdown in order to get the budget under control. Mike Pence is willing to do the same. But John Boehner, your speaker, if he is not willing to go the distance, what happens then?
Well, we're still in the process of negotiations. No one knows how this is going to play out. But certainly the Tea Party has been a tremendous force for good, David, in Washington, D.C. They've brought the ballast from the right to say, stand strong. This is why we sent you to Washington, D.C. There's three legs on this stool. There's the president, there's the Senate, and then there's the conservatives in the House. The conservatives in the House are delivering so far, and they're hanging tough. Now, I have stood strong to have defunding of Obamacare included in this bill. I appreciate the Tea Party and their willingness to stand on that issue, as well as defunding Planned Parenthood. There's issues that we have stood for, and now we'll see how it plays out. No one knows yet.
Okay, that is not even really scratching the surface, though, of what it needs, what we need to see happen, and that is slashing Social Security and slashing Medicare, along with more of the defense areas. And so I ask you, Congresswoman, if you are to do what the Tea Party wants and make all of those cuts, you do realize that some of the people who voted for you are going to be very upset when they show up and their government is not offering them what they thought they had in the past, and reality smacks you in the face, and they may not elect you again. Are you okay with that?
Well, I think that people have been very appreciative of what we've been trying to do and the fight that we've been trying to make. I hear that everywhere I go. People know that I am fighting and that the conservatives in the House are fighting. That's exactly what we're doing. And what we're looking at is finishing out the work that Nancy Pelosi failed to do, which is to pass a budget and pass the spending bills. I'm thankful that we have the chance to do that and to make the and to actually cut spending from what the Democrats would have done. So we will deliver on that score. Now, in the next budget that's coming before us, that's when we're going to be looking at tackling entitlement reform. You've rightly identified that 65% of the budget comes from entitlements. And now President Obama has given us another entitlement that we can't possibly afford under the government takeover of health care. This is just a fact. This isn't about ideology. This is a fact.
Right.
We cannot afford the government
that we have. But Fred Barnes, who I'm sure you know and appreciate, writes for the Wall Street Journal, among others. He had a piece in Monday's Wall Street Journal saying, if you attach this defunding of Obamacare as a part of the budget, the Democrats will say no. That is, the president will veto it and it won't get through the Senate, and that pretty much assures a government shutdown. Is John Boehner, I repeat, is John Boehner, your leader in the House, willing to go that distance?
Well, I can't speak for John Boehner, but I do think it's important that your viewers understand what a government shutdown is and isn't. A former member of Congress told me this week that a government shutdown would mean approximately one-fourth, 25% of the federal workforce would be furloughed. And so Social Security would continue, the military would continue, 75% of the federal government would continue, essential government services. It would be one-fourth that would be furloughed. So the government would not shut down, it would slow down. And I think it is worth the fight to defund Obamacare. After all, 58% of Americans today and over the course of the last year, no less than a majority, have said, get rid of Obamacare, because Congressional Budget Office has told us recently we will lose 800,000 jobs if Obamacare stands.
You know what,
we
though?
I'll
tell you, we've seen other polls, Congresswoman, that say that people are warming up to some ideas of it. So, you know, we got to be fair and balanced and say that some people like that your kids can stay on it till they're 26. The fact is, though, that it does cost money. You're absolutely right there. But let's move away for a moment from, as you keep calling, you know, Obamacare, so-called the health care issue, and say that there are other things. There's after-school program. There are all kinds of other issues that would just completely shut down if there is a government shutdown. And a government shutdown didn't go so well for the Republicans back when President Clinton was in office.
Well, you know, remember, who is it that wants the government shutdown? Harry Reid wants it. Howard Dean wants it. Chuck Schumer wants it. We know that from some of the phone calls that were made this week, and you've probably had that on your show. They want the government shut down because they're all about political gamesmanship. That's the last thing the American people want. They don't want us to play games. They want us to be practical and actually get some work done. That's what the conservatives in the House are trying to do right now.
Michelle Bachmann, thank you for joining us.
Thank you.
Good to see you.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.